Welcome to installment number 171 of the mitzvahs, as enumerated by Maimonides, the Rambam. Today we have one single mitzvah. It is negative commandment number 131 that prohibits us from eating something called nosar. We've actually discussed this a couple days ago, where we said that each sacrifice had a certain time period by which it needed to be eaten. And beyond that time period, its remainder, what was left over, was called nosar. And this was prohibited from being eaten. So as an example, we said if a sacrifice, its prescribed time period was until that evening, then beyond that time period, it needed to be burned. It could no longer be eaten. Now, if you recall, we also discussed another invalid sacrifice called pigel, which is the sacrifice that was brought with improper thoughts. If one had improper thoughts as to the timing of when the sacrifice needs to be brought or eaten, this too is an invalid sacrifice and therefore also cannot be eaten, of course. So these are two separate invalid sacrifices, the nosar sacrifice, the nosar of the sacrifice, the leftovers, as well as the pigel, the sacrifice that was brought with improper thoughts. However, the verbiage of the verse that we learn this from is interesting, is that it says, "Vizar lo yochal ki kodesh heim." The word heim over here is plural. So it's not talking about it, about one single sacrifice, it's actually talking about the plural. So we actually, our sages learn from here that it is talking both about both of these two sacrifices, the pigel as well as the nosar, the sacrifice brought with improper thoughts, as well as the leftover sacrifice that was brought beyond its time. And we're taught that the purpose for this commandment is just showing that, you know, the sacrifices are holy. As we said, kodesh heim, they are holy. And if somebody knows that if it's not going to be consumed in the proper time, it's going to need to be burned, which is really not such a respectable thing that would need to be done to the sacrifice, they will make sure that it gets consumed in the proper timing. And it's really just an incentive to get you to eat it properly. What really struck me, interestingly, is that we are currently celebrating the festival of Hanukkah. And what we say after we light the candles, we say about the candles that we are unable to derive any benefit from them. They are ki kodesh heim. We say the exact same words because they are holy. And because this is a specific mitzvah of bringing light into the world, it's actually a spiritual light that's meant to dispel a spiritual darkness, and we're not allowed to derive any benefit from the Hanukkah candles, but simply marvel in the beautiful light that they bring into this world. And we're meant to sit and watch them and listen to the story that the candles tell. And I just think that there's a beautiful connection here, the fact that both of these mitzvahs share the exact same word. And so we say about both of these mitzvahs, kodesh heim, they are holy. We do these things simply because they are holy. And simply because to be holy means to be separate, means set apart for a much higher cause, for a much more special calling. And this is really the purpose of every mitzvah that we do. It just sets us apart and makes us holy, brings us closer and connected to God. Have a wonderful day.